One of the groups supporting a cap on credit card charges is Positive Money. It's a not-for-profit based in London and Brussels, and it works for a fairer banking system. Fran Boait is the chief executive. Fran, the regulator's looking at high-cost credit, and it's looking at rent-to-buy and at catalogue credit and at store cards, but it's not looking at these specialist credit cards for people with poor credit history. What do you think that the FCA should do?
Well, I definitely think that the FCA should learn the lessons of payday loans where, you know, although they did regulate in 2014, which was hugely welcome and really important, it did take quite a long time for them to get to that stage and for a lot of campaigning to have to be done on how bad problem debt was for people taking out these unscrupulous loans from, you know, huge companies like Wonga. We don't want the same thing to happen again with these credit cards. And actually, they do need to kind of step in quickly and we believe to cap the total cost of interest that should be paid. But I think it is really important to see this within the bigger picture. You know, why are we seeing, you know, not just continually people with problem debt, but actually an increase in people struggling to pay for the essentials, food, rent and bills. And we need to see this within, you know, the wider economy, which has been suffering, you know, over the last decade from, you know, wage stagnation and decline, that coupled with austerity and cuts to social security and public services, as well as insecure work, means that this problem of high cost credit isn't going to go away.
Well, these may sound like high rates of interest, but the lenders have to cover the costs of the people who won't be able to repay. You know, if you're offering a specialist product for someone with people with poor credit history, and then you cap the amount that these companies can recover, won't the people with the poor credit history just have nowhere left to go?
And I think this is, you know, obviously a big part of the problem. There isn't any quick and easy answers to this. But, you know, Stella Creese is right to say, you know, at the moment you're more protected to get into, to take out a payday loan than you are to a credit card. And we obviously just heard from somebody that has had a really difficult time with high cost credit and getting into serious debt. You know, we're seeing that of those people struggling with credit card repayments, around 60% are deemed by the FCA struggling with difficulty. And what we're seeing is more evidence of mental health problems associated with high levels of debt, including anxiety and depression. And so I do think we need to think about, you know, not just the bigger picture here and actually systemic change to the kind of economy and ensuring that people are protected, which they're currently not at the moment.
Fran Boait from Positive Money, thank you.